Hey team, so I had to share this exciting adventure I've been on this week with my Color Street hostess that I'm working with. It's been really fun and kind of crazy. So I did a Facebook party with her. It started last Monday and it went from Monday till, no, it started last Tuesday and went till this Wednesday. And then she got around 150 at the party. But then so the party ended at 150. And I even did like an extra, I always do like a countdown to like, today's the last day to order. And I do like, oh, there's only 4 hours left. And then the next day I extended this sale, so we got a couple sales then on like those last few days. I noticed people tend to procrastinate, right? But anyway, so I was like, hey, let's get you. So here's some things that really helped with this party. So I had to share this, what's working with you guys. So one thing was I told her that, I made a graphic that showed like the host benefits, and I showed her what she could like get if she got to the next level. So once she got to 150, I'm like, dude, this is so exciting. But I didn't say like, okay, good, you're 150, like we're good with that. No, I was like, let's see if we can get to 300, because that would be so exciting. And I told her like, you'll get, three half price items, you'll get free shipping, you'll get 15% credit towards nails. So anyways, so I kept asking her, is there anyone else that might want to order? Is there anyone else that might want to order? And one thing that really helped, and I'm sharing that this with you today because it is follow-up Friday, and one thing that helped is we followed up. So she messaged all the people that were, not all the people in the group, but the people that were interacting and seemed interested. So she personally messaged them and like asked, said, thanks so much for joining, for participating in my party. And she said, today's the last day to order. Here's the link to order. Are you planning on ordering anything? So she did that, and then she had a couple other people say they were interested. I also did like my holiday order on her party link instead of my own. And the reason I did that, and I'm sharing that with you, is that I want my hostesses to have success. I want them to get a little taste of success, because if they get that taste, they're going to be even more likely to want to join your team and become a Color Street stylist, right? Because they're having fun and they're seeing like, oh my gosh, this is exciting. Like they're seeing the rewards. So I try to give them any little taste of success, and then we just push it a little notch further. So with her, when my hostesses get like one sale, I'm like, oh my gosh, you got one sale. Like I try, I let them know, and then I'm like, try to get them to, I think that really gets them excited when they get one sale. Another thing that helped you guys was to have, when she was really close to hitting the 300 mark, I posted in my VIP group that, hey, I've got this hostess that is having a party and she's really close to her goal. She only needs like two more people to order, buy three, get one free, and she'll hit it. And I had two more people order and do that. And then we just continue to follow up with people. That's what has been so successful about this, because we kept thinking, all right, we're gonna close the party on Thursday, and then we were like, nope, we're gonna close it on Friday, and it keeps getting extended. But it's because we keep having people that are like, oh, I'll order, sorry, I forgot. It's really just about following up. Like I even had a girl that said, yeah, I can help this girl out. I'll order this morning, and she totally forgot to. So I messaged her this morning. I'm like, hey, were you planning on, ordering? If not, no biggie, but if you do, that would be amazing. And then she did. The fortune is in the follow-up, you guys. I just had to share that because that's what I've been experiencing this week with this hostess, is she's just been like, we've both been following up like a boss, and it's been really exciting. And it's just been cool to go from 150, and now she's, and then she hit the 300 mark, and I'm like, dude, let's keep going. Like, let's go to 500. Let's see if we can get one more order. So we're trying to follow up again and see if we can get some more orders so she can hit the 500 mark. But really, it wasn't, like, hardly anyone ordered actually during the party. And I've heard some of you guys say that, like, oh, my party's a flop. And I think part of it is maybe it's not the party, maybe it's the follow-up that we're all missing out on, right? So that was my big lesson that I learned from this party was, I've got to follow up like a boss. Like, follow up with every person that is participating and that is, you know, said they were going in the event or whatever. And I wanted to share, I was talking to Erin, who's like one of my top sales girls on Team Nailed It. And she said she messages everyone. And then she also has her hostess message everyone on the last day of the sale. I mean, on the last day of the party. So, and I have to share this wording. Hopefully Erin doesn't care that I'm sharing, but it's so genius. She assumes the sale, which is a really important technique in any type of selling. You just assume that they're going to buy it. So this is her wording. She says, thanks for checking things out. I love these nails so much and I can't wait for you to fall in love too. I wanted to make sure you have the ordering link. And then she posts the link. And then she said, and I can't wait to see what you get. See, she's totally assuming the sale. And she says, make sure you share pics in our VIP group so everyone can see. When do you think you'll be able to get an order in? She's, again, assuming the sale. I'd also love to hear what you thought of my party. I'm new to this and I'm always looking for feedback from my friends. Do you mind telling me what you think? So she's like, that is a brilliant message right there for so many reasons. Number one, she's assuming the sale. She's giving them the link. Number two, she's promoting her VIP group. Number three, she's getting feedback and connecting with that person. So that is so genius to follow up with all the people in your party, or at least the people that were interacting, and see if they want to order. Because you guys, many of us are busy moms, and the people we're working with are busy moms or busy women, and it's just hard to remember, like, oh yeah, my friend had a party. Like, I will tell you right now, I've been invited to a couple parties and I get too busy to like actually participate. But if one of them messaged me and said, hey, my party ends today, are you thinking of ordering? I would be like 90% more likely to order from them than if I was participating in their party, like than if they just expected me to from their party. So again, it's all about the follow-up. And I just had to share that today because I've seen it happen. I've seen this hostess, we've gone from 150 to 300 and now we're pushing for 500. And that's the other thing, set a goal and then push for more. Like, push for more and make it happen. It's so doable. So had to share that tip with you guys today on Follow Up Friday. So that's my challenge for you, is to go out and follow up with people that might be in your Facebook party or even in your nail bar parties. Like when I did my very first mani pedi party, I followed up with people that didn't come and I said, hey, I'm so sad you weren't able to come. Are you still planning on ordering? And I had a couple people order from that. So following up is huge. Following up with prospects, you know, people that are considering becoming stylists. We have our new stylist training starting on Monday. Follow up with people that are considering joining. Let them know about this deadline. That is so important. All right, guys, have a good follow-up Friday. Bye.